Well, students, in the previous lecture, we did the derivation of the acceptance angle, IMX. Now, question is, for a good optical fiber, should the acceptance angle, IMX, be large or small? Now, just recollect what is the meaning of acceptance angle. If a ray of light is incident on the front end of the fiber, at an angle less than IMAX, then the ray will be accepted. It will undergo total internal reflection in the fiber and it will propagate through the fiber. If the ray of light is incident on the fiber at an angle greater than IMAX, the ray will not be accepted. It will not undergo TIR, but it will be lost from the sides of the fiber. So, if you want the ray to be accepted, the ray to be undergoing TIR, it must be incident on the fiber at an angle less than IMAX. Now, again the question, should IMAX be large or small for a good fiber? Obviously, larger the value of IMAX, larger the value of acceptance angle, the fiber will be better. Why? Because remember, an optical fiber basically carries data in the form of light. So, the more light it accepts, more light entering the fiber, it means you have a stronger data signal, you have a greater signal strength. So, more light will enter the fiber if IMAX is larger. Just take an example. Suppose we have two optical fibers. One, let us say, with acceptance angle of 20 degrees and another fiber, say, let us say, having acceptance angle of 40 degrees. Now, the 20 degrees acceptance angle fiber, any ray up to 20 degrees falling onto the fiber will be accepted. So, 18 degrees, 15 degrees, 19 degrees, even up to 20 degrees, it will accept. All these rays will be undergoing total internal reflection and they will propagate. But any ray like 21 or 22 or 23 degrees, anything above 20 degrees, these rays will not be accepted by the fiber. They will not propagate through the fiber. So, 20 degrees acceptance angle fiber will accept rays up to 20. Anything above 20, it will not accept. But the 40 degrees acceptance angle fiber will accept rays even 21, 22, even up to 40 it will accept. So, the 40 degrees acceptance angle fiber will accept more amount of light from the source of light. Hence, you will have a stronger signal. So, this shows us that higher the value of acceptance angle, better will be the optical fiber. Okay, next concept which we have to study about is something called as the acceptance cone of an optical fiber. Okay, now what is the meaning of an acceptance cone? Now, we know that any ray incident on an optical fiber up to an angle of IMAX will be accepted, will be undergoing total internal reflection and propagate through the fiber. Anything above IMAX will not be accepted. So now, what is an acceptance cone? You can see in this diagram here, acceptance cone, you can see this purple color cone which I have drawn. It is, acceptance cone is basically a cone having a half angle IMAX, the angle of the cone here is IMAX, and having axis as the axis of the fiber. So this dotted line which you see here, black color, is the axis of the fiber and it's also the axis of the acceptance cone. So acceptance cone is a cone having half angle IMAX, that is acceptance angle, and having axis as the axis of the fiber. Now, why do we call this cone, like drawn like this, as the acceptance cone? It's quite simple to understand. If you see all these green color rays which are drawn, all these rays are within the cone. So, all these rays will be accepted by the fiber. Now, why do I say that? It's because all these green rays will have an angle of incidence onto the fiber less than IMAX because they are within the cone having angle IMAX. So, all these rays are having or are incident on the fiber with an angle of incidence less than the acceptance angle IMAX. So, all these rays will be accepted. They will undergo TIR and they will propagate through the fiber. Now, these rays which are shown in red color outside the cone, this side as well as this side, they are rays which will not be accepted by the fiber. Why? Because they are outside the cone. For these rays, the angle at which they are incident will be greater than IMAX. Hence, they will not be accepted. So, only these rays which are within the acceptance cone will be accepted by the fiber and they will undergo total internal reflection. That's why this cone is called as the acceptance cone. Only rays within this cone will be accepted by the fiber. Okay, so the next concept is something called as a numerical aperture of an optical fiber. Now, What is numerical aperture defined as? It's a very simple definition. Numerical aperture is defined as the sine of the acceptance angle. So that is numerical aperture, in short form, write it as NA, is sine of IMAX. Now, what is IMAX? IMAX, we have a formula here. IMAX is sine inverse of all this thing. So numerical aperture is sine of IMAX. So it will become what? Sine of sine inverse of this quantity. Now, sine inverse will go cancel each other, and what will remain is only this part. So numerical aperture, which is sine of IMAX, will be just the argument in this term, sine inverse term, which is root of mu 1 square minus mu 2 square upon mu 0. So numerical aperture by definition is sine IMAX, and by formula it is root of mu 1 square minus mu 2 square upon mu 0. Now, what is the significance of numerical aperture? What do you understand by this term numerical aperture? What does it tell us about the fiber? Numerical aperture of the optical fiber be large or small? So now, the significance. Basically, numerical aperture of an optical fiber is a measure of the amount of light the fiber will accept from a source of light. So it basically tells us how much light the fiber will accept from a given source. So obviously, numerical aperture should be large. If numerical aperture is large, what does it mean? The fiber will be accepting more amount of light from the source. Let's take an example of a pipe. Okay, so let us say we have a small pipe like this, and a bigger pipe like this. Now if I ask you a question, which pipe among this will carry more amount of water? Obviously, your answer will, the pipe will be the bigger pipe. So same thing with the numerical aperture. Aperture in English, what is the meaning of an aperture? Aperture basically means a hole. So bigger the hole size, bigger the size of the opening, it will accept more water, or in this case of the optical fiber, it will accept more light. So numerical aperture is a measure of how much amount of light. So bigger the numerical aperture, bigger the opening means what? More amount of light the fiber will accept, and hence your data signal will be stronger. The light passing through the fiber will be of greater intensity. Okay, so for a good optical fiber, numerical aperture should be large. Next, one more important definition with respect to parameter of a fiber is something called as a fractional refractive index change. Okay, now what is this fractional refractive index change? We don't have any derivation for it, just a formula. Fractional refractive index change is defined as the change in refractive index of core and cladding per unit refractive index of the core. So what is the meaning of it? Change in refractive index of core and cladding means what? Refractive index of core minus refractive index of cladding. So that is the meaning of change in refractive index of core and cladding. So that is numerator. Per unit means divided by, per unit refractive index of the core. So divided by refractive index of the core. So now, refractive index of the core is mu 1 and refractive index of the cladding is mu 2. So change in refractive index of core and cladding is mu 1 minus mu 2. Per unit refractive index of core becomes divided by mu 1. So fractional refractive index change denoted by the symbol delta, capital delta, is mu 1 minus mu 2 upon mu 1. Now there's a formula which connects numerical aperture NA with the fractional refractive index change delta. Now again, the formula is given here. Numerical aperture is equal to mu 1 root of 2 delta. Again, now there's no derivation of this formula. You just have to remember it. So it can be some problems appearing in the paper based on this formula. Okay, so sometimes you may require to use this formula. So this is the relation between numerical aperture and fractional refractive index change of a fiber. Last thing what we'll be discussing in this lecture is what are called as modes of propagation. Okay, now this is an important concept because later on we'll be studying about different types of optical fibers, single mode fiber, multi mode fiber. So basically we need to know what are meant by modes of propagation. Now, what we have just said in this thing is that in the concept about acceptance cone, if you remember, we had said that any rays which are within the cone will be accepted. Any rays which are falling on the fiber having an angle of incidence less than IMAX will be accepted by the fiber. Means it will undergo TIR and it will propagate through the fiber. So how many such rays will be there? How many such rays will be there which will be accepted by the fiber? All the rays which are incident right from 0 degrees right up till angle IMAX. So let us say IMAX is 30 degrees. So a ray incident at 0 degrees, 1 degrees, 2 degrees, 3 degrees, up till 30 degrees, all such rays will be accepted by the fiber. How many such rays will be there? There will be infinite number of rays, right? So for example, like 0 degrees, 0.1 degrees, 0.2, you can have like that, divide the range from 0 to IMAX into infinite number of rays. So basically, infinite number of rays are accepted by the fiber. But then, only a few of these rays which are accepted will actually reach the other end of the fiber. Okay? Now, this is important. Number of accepted rays are infinite. Any ray within IMAX will be accepted. But not all these rays will be propagating and finally reach the other end. Now, which are the rays then which will actually reach the final end? Now, here we have to keep in mind that the wave properties of light. Okay? Now, remember, suppose this is an optical fiber. I'm just drawing the core of it. Now, let us say a ray is propagating through the fiber. Okay? Now, a ray will be accepted by the fiber if the distance between reflections. So, there is one TIR over here. There will be another TIR over here. So, the distance between the reflections should be such that a standing wave is formed between the two reflections. Only such ray directions will be allowed. So let us say this is one of the ray directions. If the ray direction is such that the distance between the reflections allows the formation of a standing wave like this. Standing wave like this. Okay. So it allows a standing wave formation. Then this ray direction will be allowed. So out of the infinite number of rays which are entering the fiber, out of the infinite number of rays which are accepted by the fiber, so this is one ray, this is another ray, this is another ray direction. There are many ray directions there entering the fiber. Only a few out of these will be satisfying this criteria that distance between reflections should be such that it allows the formation of a standing wave. Okay, so only rays which allow this criteria, fulfill this criteria, will be actually propagating through the fiber and reach the other end. So even though there are infinite number of rays accepted, only a few ray directions will be allowed. So these allowed ray directions are called as modes of propagation. Okay. So please try to understand this concept. So out of the infinite number of rays which enter the fiber, only a few ray directions, those ray directions which allow formation of standing waves between total internal reflections, only such ray directions will propagate. And these allowed ray directions out of the infinite rays, these allowed ray directions are called as modes of propagation. Now, you can have modes of propagation can be classified. So how many such modes of propagation will be there? They will be finite in number. They will not be infinite. Infinite number of rays enter the fiber, but the number of allowed directions will be only a few of them. Only those rays which satisfy distance between reflections should be allowing the formation of standing waves. Only those ray directions will be allowed. So these ray directions are classified modes of propagation, which we call them. They are classified into three categories: zero order mode, lower order modes, and higher order modes. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of zero order mode? The ray which travels along the center, along the axis of the fiber. If you see, this ray will not undergo any reflections, no total internal reflections. So there's no question of it satisfying any condition for this and all distance between reflections, because it doesn't undergo any reflections at all. So therefore, the zero order mode is always allowed. It's always allowed ray direction. Whatever may be the fiber, this central ray along the axis will always be there, because it doesn't have to satisfy any condition for reflection between distance between reflections. So it's called a zero order mode. So zero order mode is always there. Next are the lower order modes. So you see this one here, this ray, if you see, it undergoes lesser number of reflections in the same length of the fiber. It is undergoing just two reflections, so it's called a lower order mode. This ray direction, allowed ray direction, allowed mode of propagation, it undergoes more reflections within the same distance of the fiber. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, this is called a higher order mode. So, a mode of propagation which travels undergoing more reflections per unit length is called higher order mode. A ray which propagates through the fiber undergoing lesser number of reflections per unit length is called lower order mode. And a ray which doesn't undergo any reflections, that's the central ray, is called a zero order mode. Okay. So, now the number of modes, total number of modes, how many modes will be allowed? 1, 2, 3, 10, 100, how many will be allowed? That depends on the size of the core of the fiber. Greater the core size, more number of modes will be allowed. And it's inversely proportional to the wavelength. So, these are the two factors which decide how many modes the fiber will allow. So, directly proportional to the core size and inversely proportional to the wavelength. Thank you.